German to all the viewers, in this video I'm gonna deal with Anglo Maratha wars. There were total 3 Anglo Maratha wars were fought. The first one was fought during 1775 to 1782, the second one during 1803 to 1805, and the third one during 1817 to 1818. The first Anglo Maratha war, Madhavrao became the fourth Peshwa after the death of Balaji Bajirao. He was just 17 years old when he became the Peshwa, so he was unable to do the rule perfectly. That's why Raghunath Rao, who was his uncle, became his regent and de facto ruler. The important event during the Peshwaship of Madhavrao was he confined Mughal Emperor Shah Alam Second by giving him an annual pension. Madhavrao died of tuberculosis, so after his death Narayan Rao became the next Peshwa. Raghunath Rao wanted to be the next Peshwa, so he killed Narayan Rao, but the council of regency chose Madhavrao II as the next Peshwa. So infuriated at not being chosen as the next Peshwa, he went to Hyder Ali to seek his help. Hyder Ali could not help him because he was somewhere else, so Raghunath Rao went to the English to ask them for the help. The English agreed because they thought if they were helping him, they could establish the dual government as they did in Bengal. Consequently, the first Anglo-Maratha war started. The Treaty of Surat was signed between Raghunath Rao and the Bombay of Council as per in 1770. The Treaty of Surat was signed in 1775 between Raghunath Rao and the Council of Bombay. As per the treaty, the English agreed to help Raghunath Rao, and he promised to hand over Basai and Salset and a few small island near Bombay to the English. Moreover, he agreed to pay 1.5 lakh to the British to maintain the subsidiary force. The Calcutta Council rejected the Treaty of Surat. Warren Hastings sent a colonel to Nana Fadnavis to conclude a treaty. Nana Fadnavis was a strong supporter of Madhavrao II and was a bitter opponent of Raghunath Rao. The Treaty of Purandar was signed between Nana Fadnavis and Warren Hastings. As for the treaty, Madhavrao II was accepted as the Peshwa and was renamed as Madhav Narayan Rao. On the other hand, the British retained Salset and got a heavy war indemnity. Later, Warren Hastings treated the Treaty of Purandar as a scrap of paper. And allowed the operations against the Marathas. In those operations, the British got defeated and signed the Convention of Badgaon in 1779. As per this convention, the British lost everything which they got by the Treaty of Purandar. In 1782, Mahadji Sindhya signed the Treaty of Salbai. With Warren Hastings, as for the treaty, the British acquired Salset and Basai. And on the other hand, Madhavrao II was accepted as Peshwa and Raghunath Rao was pensioned off. Mahadji Sindhya, who brought Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II under his control remained the actual ruler of Delhi for 12 years, from 1782 to 1794. In 1795, Madhav Rao II also passed away. Second Anglo-Maratha War. The second phase of Anglo-Maratha War was connected with the circumstances created by the French menace to India. Governor General Lord Belleisle. Wanted the Marathas to accept the system of a subsidiary alliance. But the Marathas refused to accept. So Belleisle tried to trick the Marathas to accept the system. After the death of Nana Fadnavis, Peshwa Bajirao II played tricks to put Maratha chiefs against each other, but he himself got caught into the trap. Both Daulatrao Sindhya and Jaswantrao Holkar sought preeminence at Poona. Daulatrao Sindhya won over Peshwa, which led to the murder of Jaswantrao Holkar's brother Bithuji. Now Holkar fought against the alliance of Sindhya and Peshwa. Holkar defeated the alliance, and so now Holkar placed Binayak Rao on the throne, which made Bajirao II take English help, and the Treaty of Vasai in 1802 was signed between Bajirao II and the English, which infuriated Bhosle and Sindhya, which led to the Second Anglo-Maratha War in 1803. Bhosle and Sindhya were defeated in the war. They accepted the subsidiary alliance by concluding the Treaty of Deogaon and Surji Arjangaon respectively in 1803. The Holkar was still going strong. The British negotiated peace with him. The Battle of Vasai was a major battle of Second Anglo-Maratha War. It occurred on 23 September 1803, in which an outnumbered of Indian and British force under Arthur Wellesley, which later became Duke of Wellington, defeated the Maratha army of Daulat Sindhya and Raja of Berar. Third Anglo-Maratha War. The third phase of Anglo-Maratha War began with the coming of Governor General Lord Hastings. Peshwa Bajirao II. Was feeling uncomfortable under the British yoke. He was compelled to sign the Treaty of Poona on June 13, 1817. By this treaty, he had to give up his headship of Maratha Confederacy, and he was to conclude the relations with other states through British resident. He had also to yield Konkan and his rights in Malwa, Bundelkhand, and Northern India. Mudoji II Bhosle was also known as Appa Sahib, concluded the likewise subsidiary treaty. Governor General Lord Hastings concluded the Treaty of Gwalior in 1818 with Daulat Rao Sindhya as a part of preparation for launching the campaign against the Pindaris. Peshwa was fed up for his control by the British, so he made the last bid to throw off the British yoke. Mudoji II Bhosle, Malhar Rao Holkar and Daulat Rao Sindhya also rose in arms. Peshwa was defeated at Kirki. Bhosle's army routed at Sita Buldi. And Holkar's army crushed at Mahidpur. Peshwa's army was finally defeated at Asti. Peshwa surrendered to the British on June 18, 1818. Thus, all Maratha opposition to the British power ended. Maratha chiefs made a new settlement with the British. Peshwa surrendered his name and authority forever, and in place was given 8 lakhs of rupees as pension, and he was made to retire to Bithur near Kanpur. A small district was reserved to the descendant of Shivaji as Raja of Sataram. The remaining portions of Peshwa's territory were annexed to the Bombay Presidency. So guys, if you think my videos are really helpful, make sure you won't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye bye. See you soon in the next video.